asking this question, you know, you Muslims believe that Muhammad's night journey to Jerusalem overnight. And so it is a blatant lie, and it's apparent, and he lied to his people, and also that to the people in those days. And the Kurdish people also criticized him for lying, telling such a lie. And Muhammad said, and so he did it in overnight. But people still believe in the lie. Do you believe in that, you know? Just because of lie, we have so many issues in that area.
Can you repeat the question, sister, because you're speaking Japanese? And suddenly spoke English, I didn't realize when you started speaking English. So can you repeat the question, please?
My question.
Please, is 1 minute. The author. Both of you take the question. Where the director? The director is a fool or what? Both the cameramen should take the question, na? So he is such a good order, and both of the. दोनों ने छूट करो उसको ना, इतनी अक्कल नहीं तुम लोगों के, डायरेक्टर की जरूरत तुम लोगों के, दोनों ने क्वेश्चन बोलो ना, बाद में जन जाएगा जन पर व्यक्ति बने हो रहे ना।
Well, this is a question. I'd like to ask you, why do you Muslims believe in such a blatant lie, you know, told them by the Muslim, in the Muhammad? It is very clear that he couldn't travel to the Jerusalem overnight.
You ask me a question that why are the Muslims telling a blatant lie? That Prophet Muhammad traveled to Jerusalem overnight. That's the question.
Why do Muslims believe in the Muhammad's lie? If Muhammad is the best example of the humankind, should the Muslims lie according to him?
Sister, are you a Christian?
No, I'm a free thinker.
Free thinker, okay, fine. You know, the Bible says that Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, he parted the sea. Prophet Moses parted the sea.
I'm sorry, I don't believe in the Bible either, you know, so you cannot convince me.
I'm giving the answer. I have not finished my answer, sister. Let me finish the answer and then you can say. We believe that the prophets of Almighty God did miracles. So when Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is mentioned in the Quran in Surah Isra, chapter number 17, verse number 1, that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, it's called as night journey. He traveled from Makkah to the furthest mosque, that is Jerusalem. You saying, why do we believe in a lie? This is a miracle. You are a free thinker, I'm not a free thinker, I'm a Muslim. That's the difference between you and me. Now, why I'm a Muslim? You should have come to my talk yesterday, where I prove the existence of God. You are a free thinker who does not believe in God, correct?
That's right.
Yesterday my topic was, does God exist? I don't intend giving the full talk here. It's a 1.5 hour talk. So if it has come yesterday, by now, you would have been convinced that there is God, and you would have been convinced that this Quran is the word of God. Now your question. Is it possible for someone to travel from Makkah to Jerusalem overnight? Even you can do it, even I can do it, by plane. Prophet? It's a rhetoric question,
Well, should I
to
translate into Japanese?
No,
it's
difficult. Let's finish. Take too much time.
Okay.
So, it is, you can travel, and that time the plane wasn't there. He traveled from Makkah to Jerusalem, it's a miracle. There are many miracles mentioned in the Quran. For example, Moses, peace be upon him, he parted the sea. It's a miracle. Moses, peace be upon him, threw the staff and became into a snake. Miracle. What is a miracle? A miracle is something which cannot be proved scientifically and logically. Miracle is beyond the capacity of a normal human being. So if a normal human being, something he does, which is not possible to prove logically or scientifically, it's called a miracle. If I can prove logically, it's not a miracle. Today, if I say I traveled from Makkah to Jerusalem in one night, it's not a miracle. Even you can do it, even I can do it. At that time, when Prophet traveled, yes, it was a miracle. It was a miracle. So what we have to realize, that these are prophets of God. God is the creator of the universe, of the human beings. And God Almighty chooses a man amongst men to communicate his message with the other human beings, and this chosen men of Almighty God we call as prophets and messengers of God. So as I said in my lecture, Almighty God has sent several messengers. By name 25 are mentioned in the Quran: Adam, Noah, Abraham, Moses, Jesus, Muhammad, peace be upon them all. But the last and final messenger was Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. This is a miracle. For example, this Quran. Yesterday I gave a talk, Does God Exist? And I proved that this Quran has got more than 6,000 verses, out of which more than 1,000 speak about science. What we came to recently, about the Big Bang, about the shape of the earth, this fairy tale, light of the moon is reflected, the sun is rotating, which I did not know in school. All these things are mentioned in the Quran 14 years ago. Scientifically, no one can explain how can this book mentioned 1400 years back about the Big Bang, which we came to know just 35-40 years back. It's a miracle. How did we come to know 14 years back that the shape of the earth is geospherical? Miracle. When I was in school, I learned that the sun is stationary, it did not rotate about the axis. The Quran said that 40 years ago. How is it possible? It's a miracle. So with this, I go to prove about embryology, about botany, about biology. All scientific things that we came to recently, 50 years back, 100 years back, 200 years back, 300 years back, is mentioned in the Quran 40 years back. Who could have mentioned this? It is the Creator, who we call as Almighty God. So Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, going from Makkah to Medina, Makkah to the furthest mosque, Jerusalem, it's a miracle. And this is proving that he is a prophet of God. You and I cannot do miracles. The prophet of God, miracles are done by Almighty God through the prophet of God. Hope that answers the question.
Okay, thank you very much. But if your God is so great, you know, why didn't you turn the whole world into the Islamic nation? And why didn't you just snap their fingers and tell the world and turn it into Muslims, you know? Then you don't have to fight.
Sisters, ask a very good question. Ask a short question. Why didn't your God turn everyone into Islamic nation by snapping? This reply is given in the Quran. God knew you were going to ask this question.
I don't think so.
Then how's the reply already mentioned in advance? That is logic.
It's a coincidence.
Not for many people asked before you. So God knew you were going to ask, and God knew others are going to ask. Allah says in the Quran in Surah Yunus, chapter number 10, verse number 99, that if Almighty God wanted, He could have made all the people in the earth as Muslims. But why do you, that's the reason, don't force anyone to believe without their freedom. What's the Quran? Because Almighty God has created various creation. All the other creation of God, besides human being and jinn, they have no free will of their own. If all would have become what God wanted, then they have been angels. Angels have no will of their own. Whatever God says, they follow. That's a different creation. Almighty God created a different creation, the human beings, which has the free will to obey or disobey God. If God made all of us obey Him, then we would be like the angels. Then where is the test? So Almighty God created this special creation called as human beings, which have ability to go against God or follow God. This is the test. For example, when a teacher teaches the students appear for an examination. If the student has the textbook with them and then write directly from the textbook, then where is the test? The test is whether do they remember, do they follow the teaching of the teacher or not. So this life is mentioned in the Quran in Surah Mulk, chapter number 67, verse number 2. Alladhi khalaqal mauta wal hayata. It is God who has created death and life to test which of you is good indeed. This life you are undergoing, sister, is the test for the hereafter. Almighty God says in Surah Baqarah, chapter 2, verse 155, surely we will test you with fear or with hunger or with loss of life or with goods that you have earned. Almighty God says, your children, your wives, your wealth are a test for you. So all this is a test for us. This is the undergoing a test, sister. So what question you are going to ask? There are many things mentioned in the Quran. And Almighty God knows that certain people will question certain things. So that is the reason this we are undergoing is a test whether we follow the commandment of God or not.
programs of the bus.
Yes. But see the fact.
What we'll do, one question. You
thank
can
you
ask,
very much.
What you can do, sister, you can go behind the queue of the non-Muslims and wait for a third chance.
Sir,
you ask two questions.
Sir,
it's only
the
non-Muslims. Yes, sir, it's only the non-Muslims. Yes, sir, it's only the non-Muslims. Yes, sir, it's only the non-Muslims. Yes, sir, it's only the non-Muslims.